Welcome. I'm Jillian Kiefer, Pharmacy Technology Chair, Clinical Coordinator, and Assistant Professor. In this video, you will learn the process for compounding and shaping suppositories. Suppositories are like other compounded medications as they are made up of a base and active ingredient. Suppositories can be prepared in three different ways: rolling or hand shaping, molding or fusion, and cold compression. The method we are going to do is the fusion method. The suppository base is melted, then the drug is dispersed or dissolved in the melted suppository base. The product is then poured into a reusable or disposable mold of the volume required based on the compounding recipe needed. The active ingredient for a suppository can be in the form of a tablet, capsule, or powder. For our active ingredient, we will use a powder. The base ingredient is a solid form that melts and can solidify again. First, you will need to wash your hands thoroughly and put gloves on. We will be weighing out the powder active ingredient and base ingredient. You will need to weigh out the correct amount of powder needed for the recipe based on the calculation and compounding sheet. Make sure to place the empty weigh boat on the scale and zero it out. Then weigh the powder. Do the same process for the base ingredient. As a technician, you need to have your pharmacist on site verify the weighed amounts of your products. Using a hot plate with a stirrer, place the base ingredient in a glass beaker with a magnetic stirrer in the bottom of the beaker. Melt the base ingredient at the temperature required for the base. Each base ingredient may vary in the temperature required for the melting process. You must know this temperature as you do not want the base ingredient to burn as it will not solidify properly again. Once the base ingredient is melted, add in your active ingredient powder and let the mixture stir until it dissolves and the active ingredient is dispersed in the base. Once dissolved, remove it from the hot plate and occasionally stir it with a glass stirrer as it starts to cool down. You must let this cool down so when it is placed into the disposable molds, it is not so hot that it melts the mold. While waiting for the mixture to cool, set up the disposable molds. If the molds are opaque, use a backlight which allows you to see the mixture going into the mold. When the mixture is cooled enough, use a dosing syringe to draw up some of the suppository mixture and start placing the product in the mold based on the compounding recipe. The syringe has milliliters on it and this helps you measure the product going in as well. You must fill to just above the top line and a certain milliliter because you have to account for the volume contraction as the preparation cools. If the mixture starts to solidify, reheat it to melt it and let it cool again, and then finish filling the molds required for the prescription or medication order. Once the required number of suppositories are made, let them cool at room temperature until they are solidified. Pass a heat gun over both sides of the molds to seal the suppositories. It may be necessary to pinch them as well to seal them. Your compounding recipe should indicate what each suppository should weigh individually so you can check your accuracy of the compounded product. Once the compounding recording sheet is complete and the suppositories are sealed, they are ready to be dispensed and may be stored in the refrigerator to prevent melting. Now you know the process for the fusion method of compounding suppositories. To learn more, look for our other videos on pharmaceutical processes and techniques.